Good morning. It's Monday, June 11th, and today's title is The Beast and False Worship. Receiving the undiluted wrath of God, punished by the seven last plagues, and in the end, cast into the lake of fire, what a contrast to those who refuse the mark of the beast and stand on the sea of glass triumphantly, singing praises to God and the Lamb. What is this mark that no one would want to receive? Clearly, the above verses connect it with false worship. Also, as we saw in a previous lesson, the fourth beast of the Daniel 7, in its lighter face, also depicted the sea beast of Revelation 13, would think to change times and laws, Daniel 7:25. One law that it thought to change was the Sabbath, the fourth commandment, the only one of the 10 that refers to time and also points directly to God as one who made heaven and earth, the sea and all that is in them, and rested on the seventh day. Significantly, the first angel's message points us back to this commandment that the beast's power tried to change and make it clear that we are to worship the Lord alone as the Creator. In fact, of the seven verses referring to the worship in Revelations 12 through 14, this is the only one about true worship. The other six warn against falsely worshiping the beast and his image. Immediately after the third angel's message's description of the fate of those who engage in the false worship, the true worshipers of God are described. Here is the patience of the saints, here are those that keep the commandments of God, and the faith of Jesus. Revelations 14:12. In other words, proclamation of these messages separates all of humanity into two groups: those who worship the Creator by keeping all of His commandments, including the seventh-day Sabbath, and those who worship the beast and his image. This false form of worship then offers an alternative to worshiping the Creator of keeping the Sabbath commandment. Think more about the connection between worship and loyalty. What aspects of worship are essential in order to show our loyalty to God? Please answer in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. Please also share this message with other people and continue to watch and pray for our message. We'll see you tomorrow. Thank you. God bless you.